Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel, friends. If you're not subscribed to my YouTube channel, you have to subscribe it today and press the bell icon to receive notification about my new videos. In this video, we will see how to set up Kiosk in Windows 11 operating system. So let's get started. According to Microsoft, a single app Kiosk uses the assigned access feature to run a single app above the lock screen. When the Kiosk account signs in, the app is launched automatically. The person using the Kiosk can't do anything on the device outside of the Kiosk app that is being assigned. Now let us see how you can set up Kiosk in your Windows 11 system. So we will start with right click on the start button and select settings app. Now in the settings app, we will go to accounts, then other users. Under other users, you will find setup a Kiosk heading, and here we have Kiosk feature and we have also get started button. If you are on Windows 11 home edition, the get started button may be grayed out because the feature won't work on Windows 11 home. Now create an account and just provide a name here, for example Kiosk. Then choose a Kiosk app, and this is the only app that should be working in the Kiosk mode and the person can't use anything else. So for this example, I selected Microsoft Edge as the Kiosk app. Next, you need to provide the information how this Kiosk will be used. So here you can select a relevant option. In this case, I selected as a public browser. Then click Next. Now under the setup Microsoft Edge, you can type in a URL that will be used on the Kiosk Microsoft Edge app. And also here you can select the time in case if someone has not used Microsoft Edge, how much time after that the app should be restart in order to safeguard the public browsing session. Then click Next. And here you can see that you are done and the Kiosk mode is now set up on this device. You can just sign in with the account you just set up. And here you have also an information like when you are in the Kiosk mode, use Ctrl Alt plus Delete to exit. Now click Close here. So here you can see that the Get Started button is now removed, and here you can see the active status. The Kiosk is now active. You can just click on it and you can see all the information about the Kiosk, and you can also modify the Kiosk settings if required from this page. So all seems good. Now we will close the settings app and try to get into the Kiosk mode. Now so we have just closed the settings app and we will right click on the start button and select sign out. Now you will be signed out of the currently logged in account. On the login screen, you have to select the Kiosk name here in order to enter Kiosk mode. So Kiosk is now selected. Just click on the sign in button here. As we are signing into the Kiosk for very first time, you will be seeing the first time sign in animation, which you usually see when you log into first time to any newly created account. Now this may take a while to complete. Once the first time sign in animation has been completed, the app you selected in the Kiosk mode will be automatically launched. In this case, we selected Microsoft Edge with URL to a site, and that site is directly opened when the app is launched under the Kiosk mode. And here you have private browsing session usually. Now here you have also the end session button. You can just click on the end session here and the app will be restarted automatically. So that someone else can use it. In order to exit the kiosk mode, you have to press Ctrl Alt plus Delete. In this virtual machine, I have sent the Ctrl Alt plus Delete command from the VMware software. And once that command is sent, I see this screen where I can select sign out option. Or you can also select switch user here to go back to the login screen. And on the login screen, you can select your personal account and sign into it. And in case if you want to remove kiosk mode, you can also remove the kiosk mode from the kiosk mode settings page. That's it for now in this video. Thanks for watching it. If you found it helpful, do like it, share it, and don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos.